What is up, guys? WWE Stage Creator back again with another video, and today we will be doing the full set review of Elite 64.
I work hard every day, yeah, yeah, yeah. I work hard every day, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Starting off with the first figure, Jimmy Uso, one half of the Usos. One of the best tag teams in WWE at the moment. Here's the back if you want to read that. And yeah, let's get this bad boy open. Alright, Jimmy Uso is out of the packaging. And here he is with his accessory on. He comes with this cool cloth jacket. Says down since day one-ish on the back. Very cool there. Has a hoodie. It can't quite go over his head there. But that's okay. I'm not going to do that anyways. He should have come with a couple more accessories. At Hell in a Cell, he was actually wearing a hat, as you can see in this image there. A necklace, which he like always wears. And the Down Since Day One-ish shirts, which I do have some of those Down Since Day One-ish shirts for the figures. So I'll pop them on the two figures later. But yeah, overall, this is a very cool figure. Have a look at his head scan closer up here. And it has the new face print technology, and it looks really cool here. It's a weird facial expression for him. They usually always do this screaming weird facial expressions for the Usos, but I think this looks really cool with the beard. The hair is a lot longer here, as you can see, and yeah, very good head scan, I think. In person, not that bad. Here's the figure without the jacket on. As you can see, he has a lot of tattoos on his arm and one on his chest, one big one on his chest. And yeah, very cool figure. I really love this red attire here. Also has white boots and black socks there. Very cool Jimmy Uso figure. Now let's take a look at his brother, his tag team partner, Jey Uso. Here's Jey Uso, mint. In the packaging, looking very awesome, very excited for this figure. I think, overall, looking at it just from the packaging, I think it is better than the Jimmy Uso. But we'll just have to wait and see. Let's crack it open and find out. Here we have Jey Uso out of the packaging. Very awesome, comes with tons of accessories. We have the kendo stick right here. We have this vest on the back, says down since day one-ish. Comes with this handcuffs, which is removable, and comes with this bandana here around his neck. Also comes with two interchangeable hands here. Let's take a look at the figure without the accessories on. Okay, here it is with no accessories on. As you can see, he has a new tattoo. So it wasn't on the Elite 54. Here's a new tattoo. It has been, oh wow, on the back. I didn't even know. I can't even tell on TV that he has new tattoos, but they added it on the figure. This head scan is really nice. It is basically the same as Elite 54, but it has better face print technology and also has different hair. And the hair really makes a difference, really makes it look nice. The tattoos, pretty standard except for the new added ones on the back. And yeah, very cool figure. I definitely do recommend both Usos. They're very, very nice figures. Definitely better than Elite 54. That was like 10 series ago. So yeah, I definitely recommend these. I will pop on the Down Since Day One-ish shirts on them to get them completely accurate. Wish we would have gotten that hat with Jimmy Uso, but I mean, they kind of made up for it with that cloth jacket. But yeah, very cool Uso figures. Next up, a figure collector in his own right, Curt Hawkins, finally gets an Elite figure, and he actually gets two because he also has a Chase variant, which is black. I much prefer this attire, the red, orange and blue attire. Let's crack it open and find out how good it actually is. Okay, so before we get into the actual figure, we have this thing that it comes with. It's supposed to be some entrance stage thing when Braun Strowman put him through the entrance stage. But it's just some glass thing that's not really accurate at all. But I guess it's just for fun to throw Curt Hawkins through something. But to put it together, it took me like a good 5 minutes to figure out like what the hell to do with this thing. So basically, you got this thing, you get this side, you put it in over here, slip it right there, and then it's stand. Then you push this thing in, click it in right there. There you go. There you have it. Then you get Kurt Hawkins. You wind him up. Then, oh wow. Let's have another crack at this. Oh my god, it's indestructible. Alright, one more time. One more time, ready? What the f- Alright, surely this time it's gonna go through. Ready? Am I being pranked, Mattel? Did you really try and prank me with this one? Alright, one more time, it better break. 3, 2, 1. There we go. Still, even though you can have some fun with it, I still would have liked them to actually make something realistic to the actual raw stage so you could break them through, but still, cool little thing that they added in with this figure. Just a quick thing with this figure on the packaging, you can see he has elbow pads here on the figure. They did not include it, but I will add some elbow pads right now. Okay, let's take a look at the figure here. Here's a look at this beautiful head scan. Looks just like him. Wow, also looks like Buddy Murphy as well, which is pretty funny, the likeness between them two. Has this really cool blue and orange attire here. Says Face the Facts on the side there. Has his logo, Face the Facts again. And yeah, very cool figure. Definitely, they should have included some elbow pads to make it accurate, but don't worry, I've got some. Here we have the vest here. It is not the same as the Jey Uso vest. We have this vest has the black zipper, his logo there, Face the Facts on the back. Very cool, comes with a cane as well. Pretty straightforward, not much to show with that. Also has some fists for the interchangeable hands. I've got to try this again. Let's do it. I got to see that the other time wasn't a fluke. Alright, ready, set. Come on, Hawkins. Conquer it. Let's go. Nearly. Alright, I'm gonna smash it. I'm gonna smash it really hard. It better break. 3, 2, bang. Alright, next up we have Samoa Joe, and at first when I heard this was going to be in this set, I was thinking, why do we need another Samoa Joe? But just look at it, wow, this is the best Samoa Joe figure we have gotten ever so far, so let's get it open and take a better look. Here is Samoa Joe out of the packaging, and just look at it, fantastic figure. Comes with this Joe shirt and a removable towel. Also, the shirt's removable as well. Has these hands here, which is really cool. You can do his signature pose. And yeah, comes also with this elbow pad that's actually painted on. He never takes that off. He's always wearing that. So yeah, I think that's perfect. And I don't mind that it's not removable. And all the other Samoa Joe figures were missing that. I don't know why it took them so long to introduce that to the Elite figures. But yeah, let's take a look at it without the shirt on. Here he is without his shirt on. Let's take a better look at the beautiful new head scan of Samoa Joe. Looking just like him, way better than the other head scans we have gotten in the past. This is the best Samoa Joe figure we have gotten. Also, these hands are really nice. Let's switch them out so you can have a look at what it looks like with the other hands. Here's how you do it. You just pull it off a little bit. You don't pull too hard. The first time, you always have to give it a little bit more. Push that in. And it's in. And there you go. He can hold his microphone or weapons or whatever you want him to hold. And yeah, very cool Samoa Joe figure. Definitely the best. His attire is pretty straightforward. Just red and black. Oops. Also, he has these white holes on the knee pads. And yeah, very cool Samoa Joe figure. Highly recommend it. Here we finally have Seth Rollins with a beautiful new head scan. I am ready to burn it down with this figure. I am super pumped to have this in the collection. This is the Royal Rumble 2018 attire. So let's get it out of the package. Seth Rollins is out of the packaging, looking awesome, looking fire. And yeah, this is really awesome. Finally, my prayers have been answered and we get a normal, good-looking Seth Rollins head scan. None of this screaming crap, none of this laughing crap, none of this whatever the hell this is. We get a normal-looking head scan. Unfortunately, on mine, the hairpiece is a little bit screwed up, but I did pick up the top talent Seth Rollins, so hopefully, I haven't taken a look at it yet, but hopefully it has a good head scan, a little bit better than this one. Still overall really good. Comes with the Raw Tag Team Championship. I'm sure you guys have seen that before. And we have this Flames attire, debuted at the Royal Rumble. Very nice, has the SR logo on the knee pad right there, and the flames continue on the back. Yeah, pretty cool figure. Wish it came with a shirt, but I do have plenty of custom Seth Rollins figure shirts to add on to this figure, so I definitely will do that. Very nice Seth Rollins figure. Next up, and last but not least, we have John Cena in his 2018 neon green and purple attire. Very nice figure. I just can't wait to get this open, so let's do it. All right, here he is, John Cena. And it is a very vibrant, cool-looking figure here. I'm really liking it. Same old head scan we've been getting for a while now. I really wish they added the longer hair look, but, you know, whatever. Definitely needs to be on the next one from the Super Showdown attire. Here is a look at his hat. Very detailed. Has the logo here, logo there, and there. Pretty standard. Has the very nice shirt here, actually one that fits and is not super small like all the other ones. Has his dog tags and nothing on the back, just the Velcro thing there. And has these cool looking shoes with the blue, black, and white. Now let's take a look. Oh my. Let's take a look without the shirt on. Cena comes with this armband that is removable, but I do not want to remove it right now. Also comes with two interchangeable hands here, the You Can't See Me hands, which I will swap right now. I only swapped it on the left or the right hand because he does it like this, the five knuckle shuffle, you can't see me, and then he hits him in the face. But yeah, very cool. I'm really liking this You Can't See Me hand. I'd also like to see in the future a Hustle, Loyalty, and Respect hand, which would be cool. And yeah, very cool John Cena figure. I'm really liking it. The colors of the shirt and the attire really stands out in the collection. After reviewing all these figures, now it's time to rank them. My number one, Seth Rollins right there. Doesn't come with the burnt down shirt, but I included it. But yeah, very cool figure. Number two would be Kurt Hawkins for me. Very vibrant, very cool figure. And the likeness is just perfect. The next one would be Samoa Joe. Likeness is just fantastic on that figure. Next would be the Jey Uso. Very cool figure. Comes with a lot of cool accessories as well. Next would be John Cena. Very vibrant. I really love that attire. And also, the next last one would be Jimmy Uso. But all fantastic figures. This is one of the best Elite sets in a long time. I definitely do recommend every single figure in the set. I picked these up from Ringside Collectibles, WrestlingFigures.com. Got them before they came into stores, so if you want to get your stuff early, WrestlingFigures.com, Ringside Collectibles, definitely the place to go. Discount code STAGES will save you 10% on all purchases. Thank you guys for watching this video. I spent a lot of time doing this, so please leave a big thumbs up. Comment down below which figure you like most from the set. Follow me on Instagram at WWE_stage_creator for daily figure picks, including figure picks of these figures. And subscribe if you haven't to this channel for more reviews like this. And I'll see you guys on the next video.